Hi, welcome to my talk. I am Madhav and I will be presenting our work, Making Volatile Indexes Persistent Using TIPS. This is a joint work in collaboration with Wuki, Yiwan, Minsung, Sumit, Ajit and my advisor Dr. Chang Wu-min. TIPS is a framework to make volatile indexes persistent. TIPS neither places restrictions on the concurrency model, nor it requires in-depth knowledge on the volatile indexes. As of the guarantees, TIPS guarantees durable linearizability and also guarantees memory leak free recovery. At its core, TIPS adopts a novel DRAM NVMe tiering approach and its concurrency model, which we call the tiered concurrency model, which is key to achieve high performance and scalability. On top of our DRAM NVMe tiering approach, we build the UnoLogging and hybrid synergistic logging approach for achieving low overhead crash consistency. In total, we converted 7 volatile indexes with different concurrency models and the Redis key value store application using TIPS. Our evaluation shows that TIPS outperforms other conversion techniques by at least 3 times and the NVMe optimized indexes by at least 2 times. With the advent of non-volatile main memory, a numerous number of NVMe optimized indexes are proposed in the past and current literature. But maturing and hardening an index requires a lot of time and effort. As a result, the current crop of NVMe optimized indexes has several critical limitations, such as supporting a weaker consistency guarantee and not addressing persistent memory leaks, etc. Such limitation delimits these indexes from being adopted into the real world applications. On the other hand, there are already decades of research on DRAM indexes, and more importantly, there are many well-engineered DRAM indexes that have been widely deployed in the real-world applications. We believe that it is important to leverage such DRAM indexes for NVMe software, which will save a lot of development effort and also expedite the adoption of NVMe into the real-world applications. Prior works also show that manual porting of legacy applications for NVMe is complex and error-prone. So it is critical to provide a systematic path for the developers to convert DRAM-based indexes and legacy applications for the NVMe software. Very recently, a few conversion techniques and guidelines have been proposed. These techniques limit themselves to support only a specific concurrency model. For example, NVTraverse targets the conversion of lock-free indexes, while Pronto targets only the blocking indexes. This makes such techniques to have limited applicability. On the other hand, while Recipe has relatively a better applicability, it supports only a weaker consistency guarantee. That is, a linearizable DRAM index converted using Recipe can support only buffered durable linearizability. Supporting buffered durable linearizability makes the conversion process more complex, and moreover, a weaker consistency guarantee may not be suitable for many cases. The table shown here extensively compares the existing conversion techniques based on its applicability, conversion method, consistency guarantee that the technique offers, and many other aspects. The red blocks mean the limitations, and the green blocks mean the benefits offered by the respective techniques. Unfortunately, there is no one single technique that satisfies all the requirements. To address this problem, and with the goal to make the overall conversion process simple, we propose the TIPS framework. TIPS is designed with three main goals in mind. First, we strive to achieve an index-agnostic conversion and support strong consistency and correct recovery. Most importantly, we strive to achieve these two goals without trading off the performance or the multi-core scalability of the volatile index. By achieving index-agnostic conversion, we strive not to place any restrictions on the concurrency control of the volatile index like the prior conversion techniques does. We also aim to make the overall conversion process simple and generic without requiring any index-specific knowledge. Finally, we aim to provide a uniform programming model to convert all indexes, and importantly, hiding the complexities of NVMe programming under the hood, so that even the developers with limited knowledge on NVMe programming are able to use TIPS effectively. Second, to achieve our second goal, we aim to provide strong consistency, that is, achieve durable linearizability which is key to achieving correctness and make the conversion process less error prone. We also aim to guarantee a fast and memory leak free recovery, as persistent memory leaks are one of the critical problems in the NVMM that definitely needs to be addressed to ensure correctness and safety. To avoid enlisting any industry-specific guidelines like the recipe or NVDrivers, we aim to provide a low overhead and industry-agnostic crash consistency mechanism in TIPS. Finally, we aim to retain the original performance and scalability characteristics of volatile index, and ideally, we would like the TIPS-enabled index to scale and perform better or at least on par with the NVMM optimized indexes. Lastly, we aim to make the TIPS enabled indexes to perform better than the prior index-specific conversion techniques. The figure here on the right shows the overall architecture of TIPS framework. The TIPS frontend consists of DRAM cache, which contains the recently written key-value pairs, and also contains a per-thread operation log to guarantee crash consistency for the writes that happen on the DRAM cache. The backend consists of user-defined index, which we call the plugged-in index. For the illustration purpose, let us consider the B+3 as the user-defined index in all our examples moving further. Lastly, the backend also has an undo log and a memlog to guarantee crash-consistent updates to the plugged-in index. Now that we have an overall idea of TIPS architecture, let me illustrate how an application write request is handled within the TIPS framework. Upon a write request, the writer first makes the operation durable by logging it in the per-thread OLog, which is the durability point in TIPS. From this point, the write operation is guaranteed to survive a crash. After committing the write in the OLog, the writer then proceeds to add the key value pair in the DRAM cache to make the writes visible to the readers. This is the linearization point in TIPS, and at this point, the writes are deemed to be complete. As we can infer, only durable writes are visible to the readers, and hence an application is guaranteed to see all the data that it read across power cycles. Thus, TIPS guarantees durable linearizability. Overall, all the write operations succeed in the TIPS frontend, and more importantly, regardless of the concurrency model supported by the plugged-in index, TIPS can process the write request concurrently using its DRAM cache. With this, we achieve our first goal of guaranteeing durable linearizability in TIPS. Now that we have seen how writes are handled in the frontend, let me illustrate how the frontend writes are propagated to the user-defined B+3 on the NVMM. To propagate the updates to the user-defined B+3, TIPS employs a separate background combiner thread to combine all the OLog entries in a per-worker queue. Then the combiner thread spawns multiple background workers, which then sort and replay the OLog entries to the B+3. Note that unlike the writes to the frontend, the backend writes to the B+3 are, for that matter, writes to any plugged-in index will follow the concurrency model supported by the plugged-in index itself, which may or may not be concurrent. For example, say if our B+3 in the example uses a reader-writer lock, then the background writes can only be processed sequentially. Alternatively, say if our B+3 supports a lock-free writes, then the background writes can be concurrent. Moving on with our example, now let us consider a worker trying to insert into the B+3. Once it gets to the leaf node, it first logs the leaf node in the undo log, and then it inserts the key value pair into the leaf node. Here, the undo logging is necessary to guarantee crash consistency. Also note that the address of the leaf node A will be logged in the mlog during its allocation time itself, which will be used by the TIPS during the recovery process to identify and fix persistent memory leaks. Finally, the worker proceeds to the DRAM cache to invalidate the corresponding key value pair entry, and it continues its replay cycle. Okay, now that we have seen how the entries, especially the writes, are handled, let us see how a read request is handled within the TIPS framework. First, the reader thread looks for the target key in the DRAM cache, and if the target key is found, then it is returned to the application from the DRAM cache itself, that is, without having to traverse the B+3 index on the NVMM. The key benefit here is that, regardless of the concurrency model of the plugged-in index, that in our case the B plus V, all reads hitting the DRAM cache can be processed concurrently, as DRAM cache in TIPS supports lock-free concurrent reads. On the other hand, if the target key is not found on the DRAM cache, the reader will be redirected to the B plus V index on the NVMe, and the target key will now be returned from the TIPS backend following the read concurrency model supported by the B plus V. From the previous illustrations, it is clear that there exist two levels of concurrency in TIPS framework. That is, the operations that succeed on the front end, for example, all write operations and read hits, will follow the concurrency model of the DRAM cache, and the operations that succeed in backend, for example, the backend writes while replying the operational log and the read misses on the DRAM cache, will follow the concurrency model of the plugged-in index. We call this two-level concurrency model as the tiered concurrency. One of the key benefits of this tiered concurrency is that it allows TIPS to embrace and support different concurrency models by allowing the concurrency model of the plugged-in index to coexist with the DRAM cache. Moreover, if the plugged-in index uses, say, a mutex as its concurrency control, it can still take advantage of the DRAM cache to process the reads and writes concurrently and consequently achieve a good performance and scalability. Additionally, it also offers other useful properties such as reduced DRAM footprint and high capacity scaling. The tiered concurrency model also leverages the original characteristics of the volatile index for its performance. For example, if the plugged-in index is designed to support concurrent reads and writes, the overall read performance and write performance can also improve. Revisiting our goal chart, we can now check the two other goals, one towards achieving index agnostic conversion and other towards achieving high performance. The next question we would like to answer is how to convert the existing volatile indexes codebase using TIPS. Let me illustrate with an example of an open chaining hash table, and the code snippet on the left here is the usual implementation of a volatile open chaining hash table. It shows the insert logic, and I would quickly like to walk through the code. The code here gets to the hash bucket and traverses the bucket to find the existing node. If a node is found, the code here simply updates the value field in the existing node and terminates. Else, a new node is allocated, returned, and added to the bucket. Now, to convert this code using TIPS, the first step is to replace the memory allocations with TIPS alloc, which will allocate memory from the NVMe heap and also internally take care of logging the allocation in the mlog. Next, before modifying any NVMe address space, undo logging API is added. In particular, here, before updating the existing node at the M2 and before updating the next pointer of the previous node at M3. And now the hash table is made persistent. It is important to note that this conversion process is same for all the other indexes, regardless of its concurrency model, and the same is applicable to complex indexes that requires multi-pointer updates, such as the B plus tree or a radix tree. Finally, the table here summarizes the complete set of TIPS provided APIs, which are classified as facade APIs that can be used to access the plugged-in index from the application code. And the next set of APIs is called the plugin APIs, which should be used to modify the existing volatile code base to be plugged into the TIPS framework. These two sets of APIs make up the plugin programming model in TIPS. Now, with our plugin programming model, developers do not require in-depth knowledge on the volatile code base to modify using TIPS. So, and also, we hide the complexities of NVMe programming, such as logging, persistence guarantee, etc., under the API, so the developers do not have to consider them explicitly. And we believe this will make the overall conversion process significantly simple and also less error prone. TIPS frontend, with its concurrent DRAM cache and per-thread operation logging, is extremely fast when compared to the backend. As backend writes, backend writes, that is the writes to the plugged-in index, are inherently slower because the all writes are happening on the NVMe, and additional undo logging can make it much worse. Moreover, there can be high latency structural modification operations such as a tree split or a tree rotation, say if a plug-in index is a B plus tree or an RB tree. The issue with this is that a slower backend can easily bottleneck the fast frontend as the space in the operation log in the frontend is very limited. Considering these factors, it is critical to make the backend writes fast to be able to keep up with the frontend writes. To make the backend writes fast, we introduced two techniques: Unologging protocol to reduce the undo logging overhead in the backend, and adaptive scaling for concurrent background writes. Now let us look into these two techniques in detail, and first is the Unologging protocol. Our previous illustrations of TIPS architecture introduced three different logs, namely the operation log in the front end, undo log in the back end, and mem log in the also in the TIPS back end. All three logs in TIPS are not disjoint, rather they work synergistically, and this enables TIPS to selectively perform undo logging only for the addresses that are required for a correct recovery. The key idea here is to perform undo logging only if the requested address is not present in the O log or if the address is not already logged in the undo log. This decision is made using the two timestamp information, namely the time at which the requested address is allocated and the time of the last O log reclamation. Let me illustrate this decision making process in the next few slides. Now let us consider a scenario where the worker thread has to replay the OLog entries to the plugged-in index, in our case a singly linked list. Now an entry has to be added at the tail, so the worker proceeds to allocate a new node and writes the key value pair to it. Then before modifying the next pointer of the node D, it checks if it needs to perform undo logging by checking the node D's allocation timestamp and reclaim TS of the OLog. In this case, alloc TS of node D is less than the reclaim TS, which means that the OLog has been reclaimed since the node D has been allocated, and this guarantees that the logic to create node D will not be present in the OLog. Now with the OLog information being sorted out, the worker checks if the node D has been logged in the undo log as a result of any previous write request. But again it's not, so the worker proceeds to add node D in the undo log and then modifies the next pointer of the node D to point to node E. The key takeaway here is that the node D was neither in the OLog nor in the undo log, so undo logging for this case is mandatory to ensure crash consistency. Now let us consider the replay of next entry in the OLog. Again, before modifying node E, the worker thread checks the alloc TS of node E, and this time the logic to create node E is guaranteed to be present in the OLog as it hasn't been reclaimed since the node E is allocated. So in this case, undo logging is skipped and node E is modified to point to the node F. Finally, let us consider the next entry, in this case an update operation on an existing node. With the timestamp information, worker finds that node D is not in the OLog, but when it traverses the undo log, it can find that the node D has been already logged in the undo log as a result of previous write. So the undo logging is skipped and node E is updated to point to the new value. As illustrated in case 2 and 3, using undo log in synergy with the operation log can significantly reduce the number of undo loggings performed. For instance, reimagine the same scenario, say in case of a B plus tree with a fan out of 256. In the best case scenario, the leaf node must be undo logged only once, and the same undo log record can be reused for the rest of the writes to this leaf node. And this will save a significant number of undo logging performed in the TIPS backend. The key benefits of Unologging idea is that it makes the backend writes fast by reducing the undo logging overhead. It also offers other rich set of properties such as preventing persistent memory leaks and offering a low overhead crash consistency in the critical path with the use of operation logging. And more importantly, the idea of Unologging is index agnostic. That is, it can be applied to any index irrespective of its type or a concurrency model that it supports. Revisiting our goal chart, now we have achieved our goal of providing strong consistency and correct recovery with the idea of unologging. Next, let us see our next idea to make the backend writes faster, which is the adaptive scaling for concurrent background writes. In the previous illustrations, we saw that the background writes in TIPS is concurrent, but this raises two important questions. First, is merely making a backend concurrent good enough for achieving high performance? And the more pertinent question is how to determine the right number of workers. This is a critical question given that the plugin index can have different concurrency model. So one brute force approach is to maintain one worker for every foreground writer. But this approach has two main problems in our view. One, if the workers are idle, it leads to wastage of CPU cycles and other critical hardware resources. And it also limits the application from scaling beyond one NUMA socket. So to address this problem, we propose adaptive scaling algorithm for dynamically decide the number of concurrent background workers based on the nature of workload and the write scalability of the plugged-in index. The key idea of adaptive scaling is to monitor the write throughput of the front-end and back-end. And the goal is to maintain the throughput ratio between the front-end and back-end as much as close to 1. That is, the rate at which the OLog is filled in the front end and the rate at which the OLog is consumed by the back end should be approximately the same to keep the system stable. In the scenario where front end is faster, that is, OLog is being filled at a faster rate than it is being consumed, then adaptive scaling will scale up the number of workers. Alternatively, if the OLog is being filled at a lower rate, then to avoid having many idle workers in the system, the adaptive scaling will scale down the worker count. So to put this idea into perspective, let's say if a workload is write intensive, the OLog will be filled at a faster rate. And to keep up with that pace, the worker count will be scaled up. And similarly, if the workload is, say, read intensive, we may not need as many as workers. So the number of worker count will scale down. Also, adaptive scaling memorizes the best performing worker count while it scales up. And once the worker count reaches the upper bound, it simply falls back to the best performing worker count and never scale beyond that again. This is an important design aspect because not all plugin index will scale linearly with the increase in the number of background writers. At some point while scaling up, the write performance may collapse or at least saturate. Once that point is reached, it is prudent to fall back to the worker count which achieves the peak performance rather than continuously using the maximum number of writes or keep scaling up. To conclude, adaptive scaling will dynamically decide the worker count based on the nature of the workload and the write scalability of the plugin index. By evaluating TIPS, we would like to answer the following questions. First, how many lines of code changes are required in the existing volatile code base for the conversion using TIPS? Then, how does the TIPS-enabled indexes fare against the indexes converted using the prior state-of-the-art index conversion techniques? And finally, we also like to compare the performance of TIPS-enabled indexes with the NVMe-optimized ones. For our evaluation, we use a 2-socket 64-core Intel server equipped with real NVMe. We use YCSB workloads with 32 million keys, and the table below summarizes the nature of different YCSB workloads. In all our evaluations, we set our DRAM cache size to cache a maximum of 25% of the total keys, which incurs an additional 300 MB of DRAM space. We compare the performance of TIPS against the state-of-the-art index conversion techniques such as Pronto, NVTraverse, and Recipe, and also against the state-of-the-art NVMe optimized indexes. The table presents the list of indexes that we converted using TIPS and the lines of code changes required for each of these indexes. In total, we converted 7 volatile indexes with different concurrency model and a real-world key value store application Redis using TIPS. Overall, our conversion requires less than 10 lines of code, which is a modest number, and more importantly, these changes are simple and does not require an in-depth knowledge on the volatile index as we previously illustrated in our hash table example. The graph shown here compares the performance of TIPS-enabled B plus tree against the B plus tree converted using Pronto, which is a state-of-the-art index conversion technique for blocking indexes. The x-axis represents the YCSB workloads and y-axis the throughput. Higher the better. The number presented here are for 32 concurrent threads, and as we can see, TIPS outperforms Pronto by up to 14x, and this performance can be attributed to the fast and concurrent TIPS frontend. Although both TIPS B plus tree and Pronto B plus tree supports only a single writer as it uses a reader's writer's lock for its concurrency, TIPS can still process the writes concurrently using its DRAM cache in the frontend and eventually a better performance and read-write performance than Pronto. Next, the figure here shows the performance of TIPS-enabled lock-free BST and the lock-free BST converted using NVTraverse, which is a state-of-the-art index conversion technique for the lock-free indexes. As illustrated in the figure, TIPS outperforms NVTraverse by up to 3 times, and this is mainly because of high number of P barriers required to ensure crash consistency in NVTraverse. To add more perspective, a write operation in NVTraverse incurs up to 17 P barriers, while a read operation in the same incurs more than 3 P barriers. On the other hand, in TIPS with the UNO-logging, the number of P barriers are significantly reduced and mostly hidden in the background. A write operation in TIPS incurs only 3 P barriers, while the read operation does not require any. Hence, a better performance than NVTravers. This figure shown here compares the performance of TIPS-enabled ART against the recipe ART and also against the WART, which is an NVMe-optimized ART variant. Note that TIPS-enabled ART supports a stronger consistency, that is durable inerasability, while recipe ART supports only a weaker consistency guarantee. In spite of that, TIPS still outperforms or at least performs on par with weakly consistent recipe ART across all workloads. Also, TIPS outperforms WART index. This is because WART is single-threaded. But on the other hand, TIPS with its tiered concurrency model is able to support a concurrent front-end and back-end for the ART index and consequently a better performance. Finally, the graph here compares the performance of TIPS-enabled B plus tree against the state-of-the-art NVMe-optimized B plus tree variants, FastFair and BZ tree. The table on the right summarizes the concurrency model of the indexes compared. TIPS outperforms BZ tree up to 5x and performs mostly on par with FastFair except for workload C, which is a read-only workload. For workload C, FastFair is faster than TIPS because FastFair is designed for cache lane efficiency, and with its smaller fanout, it supports fast point queries. TIPS B plus tree, on the other hand, with a larger fanout, provides good range query performance than FastFair as it better exploits the fast sequential reads on the NVMe. Revisiting our goal chart for the last time, from our evaluation, it is clear that TIPS optimized indexes performs on par with NVMe optimized indexes, and it also outperforms the other index specific conversion techniques as well. As we come to the end of the talk, we would like to thank and appreciate all the previous index conversion works, to name a few, Recipe, Pronto, and NVTravers, for taking this important research direction and also for making their source code and benchmarks publicly available. The current version of TIPS focuses on converting only the indexes, and as a future direction, we would like to extend TIPS to support conversion of primitive data structures. To conclude, the current index conversion techniques have several limitations, such as limited applicability, supporting only a weaker consistency, etc. So we propose TIPS, a framework to make volatile indexes persistent in an index agnostic way. TIPS offers several benefits such as not placing restrictions on the concurrency model, providing strong consistency and correct recovery. All this in addition to providing an outstanding performance over the prior index conversion techniques and NVM optimized indexes. Thank you for taking time to watch my talk. Please feel free to reach out to me with any questions. I'd be happy to answer them. Thank you.